one last question I have, which is also about the presentation of the interview or how you should be in the interview. So why this question came was because especially in the private sector, when you interview somebody, then usually the candidate is expected to be oozing personality, as I call it. That, you know, the person should be oozing with energy and personality. That is usually the criteria, that somebody who is dull or who is very formal is not considered to be a great candidate when it comes to the private sector employment. So what kind of demeanor I should be having with the board? You know, for example, candidates ask these questions also, that when I look at them, and let's say if the board is asking me a question and I'm looking at the gentleman or the lady asking me a question, should I be smiling at him or her, or should I just be without a smile, with a straight face? So the idea is, where is the balance of formality? How formal should I be with them? And what kind of body language and demeanor should I keep? That should I appear to be very energetic young person, or should I be very formal person? What exactly is the ideal body language in your opinion?
The UPSC interview is a very formal interview.
Right.
And so for anybody who has a doubt, please wear your suits. Please wear a tie. For ladies, you should definitely wear a sari. A salwar suit is not a very formal attire. Or like if you are very comfortable with a pantsuit, fair enough. But what I'm trying to say is, it's a very formal interview. So you cannot appear to be flippant.
Okay.
Yeah, being energetic and appearing to be flippant, I think there is a line. So it is good to appear energetic. And I would always say, please look whoever is talking to you in the eye. Hmm. Maintaining eye contact gives a lot of confidence to the board that you are not somebody who is nervous or reticent or shy. So please look anybody who is talking to you in the eye. Maintain a very calm, composed demeanor. Smile if it is needed. If your natural demeanor is to, if you have a smiling face, let it be like that. So, but again, don't try to force a smile on your face. Right. Because you have a natural demeanor. Like the way you are looking at me right now, I think that's a perfect demeanor to be sitting in an interview board. There is, I won't, so, maintain your natural demeanor, but your body language should not be suggestive of the fact that you are not taking it seriously, that you are being flippant, that you are being playful. So you have to maintain all the sincerity in front of the board. Because let us understand, these are, let us also look at the interpersonal aspect of it. If anybody who's sitting in the board at least has a 30-year service behind him.
Right.
He has gone through this stage, and where you want to reach, he has been there for the last 30, 35 years.
Right.
He has seen people like you coming into the service almost every year, because every service has people coming in every year. So basically what I'm trying to say is they deserve some respect. Hmm. The board should not feel that you are being disrespectful.
Hmm.
The board should not feel that you are trying to teach them.
Hmm.
You can always present your point. The board says something, you can disagree as well. I disagreed on my board, and I still remember that incident where one gentleman asked me about community policing. And I mentioned, sir, he asked me something, do you think our society is right for community policing? And I said, sir, in my humble opinion, I feel that we are beyond the question of whether community policing should be there in the society or not. We should be trying to find out ways and means as to how to make police. He was asking about police, like police being friendly to citizens.
Hmm.
So I said, we are beyond a stage where we should be discussing about whether the police should be friendly or not. Police are civil servants at the end of the day.
Hmm.
They are employees of the state who are recruited to give a service to the people of the state. And we should be discussing ways, we should rather discuss ways and means about how to do it, rather than whether we should do it or not.
Right.
So I disagreed with him, and I was given reasonably good marks. I think I was given the highest marks in the board, which anybody got in that board. is my understanding. In any case, it would be high, generally the highest kind of a marks. So I don't think there is, what I'm trying to say is, there is nothing which says that you should not disagree with them.
Right.
You can disagree, you can put across a point, but if they stress something another time, a second time, respectfulness demands that you say, sir, I will probably read up about it, or I'll probably understand it more. And right. Just leave it at that. You are not there to win a debating competition with the interview board member.
So counter argument should not be given.
Should not be done. He asks you something, you say something, and if he pushes too much against your opinion one more time, you should say, sir, which will generally happen, if it is a disagreement which is happening now, in that case, I would say after first attempt, back off.
Okay.
Don't get into an argument. It is not an argument. It is not a match of arguments.
Right. So it should be extremely formal and...
Extremely formal. Be extremely formal. No need to have a scowl on your face. As that is why I said, have a normal demeanor. Have a normal demeanor. If you normally smile, do smile.
Right. Okay, great. That is all we have for now. Thank you so much for your time, Sir Faraz. I know you are a very busy man, and still you have found time. And I think you're frozen. Now I could see you. Thank you so much, Sir Faraz, for the time. And I'm sure this conversation will be able to help a lot of people. And it will also give some much required clarity to a lot of aspirants, and probably they will do better, and they will do they will at least feel slightly more comfortable going in for the interview. That is the basic idea. Who will do better, who will not, that we can't really predict or talk about, but at least they will feel slightly more comfortable without queries. Thank you so much for your time.
Just one disclaimer. The language and all of what the disagreement which I had with the board is not of the nature that I remember exactly what happened 14 years back on that day.
Right.
It is basically more to give an idea.
Right.
Thoughts. So no, I am not claiming that this is the language that I used.
Right. Right.
So obviously. It was a small disagreement. The point I was trying to make at that time was that you can also disagree with the board. There is nothing which says that you have to agree with the board. You shall agree with the board.
Right, right. Great. Thank you so much, Sir Faraz, for your time. And
thanks,
thank you so much.